Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Legend of Amberland. As per usual, we were just picking up where we left off, and where we had left off, we killed a freaking dragon! Feels good, man. We do have a couple caves left on this island yet to kill our way through, and I can't imagine these are going to be too bad. So this is the Deep Mine, and this is the Mithril Mine. Alright, well, I guess we'll start with the Mithril Mine. Oh! This is a freaking town. Okay. Large plaque. Welcome to Dwarf Town. Dwarven Miner. We have mined too deep, and now these monstrosities emerged. Still, it's much better than the Deep Mine, which has become so infested that we had to abandon it. Are we gonna have to go, like, Deep Mine Alpha and Beta and all of that crap? Oh, yeah. Mining Zone. Locked room. The occupant has left to do some mining. Oh, I wonder if there's maybe a trapped miner in here somewhere. Okay, if I recall correctly, these dudes paralyze. Yeah. Alright, so I want to go ahead and get Vitality going. I think that's probably all we'll need. Back row can just magic arrow. Go ahead and cure Paralysis. And I'll get, I guess, Magic Shield going. Why not? Devon's not using those spell points for anything else. Because, yeah, now that these things can't paralyze us, they're, I won't say defenseless, but they are, like, next to no threat. Although, apparently they can petrify you. That's interesting. I wasn't expecting that. I don't think I have a petrification cure in the party. I was not expecting something like that. Do I have, I might have petrification cure. I'll have to look through stuff. Alright, do we have petrifying curing? I don't believe we do. We do not. That is moderately annoying. We will continue on without Chunk. I think that was these guys that did it. Friggin' level 12. You come in here at level 12, you don't even have, like, paralysis removal at that point. That'd be terrible. Alright, let's go ahead and get a mass heal going. And I'm gonna, I guess, have my back row start throwing, like, fireballs. Just kind of work these things down a little bit more quickly. Mostly for, like, groups like this, because, like, individually these guys aren't hard. I just want to expedite the murder a little bit. And the back row certainly has the mana for it. I'm not worried about Chunk being petrified throughout this, because the biggest reason that I would be worried is experience point loss, of all things. Because in a game like this, monsters don't respawn, so if, like, a character dies and they don't gain XP when they're dead, that means that they're going to permanently be behind the rest of the party, and that shit just does not sit right with me when it comes to larger scale RPGs like this. But they kind of got around that by just letting characters continue to accrue experience points even when they are incapacitated, however that may be. Alright, well, that was one branch. Do you guys have a healer here? I wasn't paying attention. I know you got an inn. Is that it? Just a shop and an inn? Yeah. Alright, that's fine. I wonder, what is this? Oh, another mining zone. I actually have an idea. Recovery? Oh, doesn't cure it. I tried. As a waste of an ability. It's okay. I would like to get Chunk back because he expedites the murder. Oh, there's another. Alright, here we're gonna pull out. And I'm gonna freaking wing us right over here. So that we can go and get Chunk back into a more pliant form. Let's see, I think it's restoration. Because the other one is just, here, have some strength. The other one is just hit point restoration. And for that, we can just rest. And it saves us so much money. Let's see, where was in? I'm sure we probably have levels, or at least close. I honestly don't think we need to do that yet, though. I'm not particularly worried. The biggest gripe I could say that I have about this game at this point is that there doesn't really seem to be a whole heck of a lot to do with money. Because, like, by far, all of the best gear we have is stuff that we've found. And I'm okay with that. But the downside to it is, like, why bother giving us gold? Seriously? Alright. Chunk, are you, like, my one front row? Yeah, you're the one front row that doesn't have petrification immunity. Alright, well, in that case, he's just gonna stay a statue then, because, yeah, it seems like these things, like, single-target attack petrifies you, and Chunk can't deal with that, apparently, so, you know. It's okay, that is what it is. We'll just continue murdering our way through here. He's getting XP. These things are just taking slightly longer to kill. I think we'll be okay. I do still really like the dungeon design in this game. How, like, not every dungeon is, like, this massive labyrinth. It's like, yep, that's a mine. Alright. I suppose you guys are happy with us? Nope. They don't give a shit. Alright, and this is just more of the same, so Chunk is going to just stay a statue, I guess. We got triple eyes, we got double eyes, we got eyes with eyes. Okay, God, that is a lot of these things. Not too worried, it's just, look at all that everywhere. I do apologize, you probably won't be able to hear it. I think it's pretty quiet, but there are going to be airport noises. I had to record these a little earlier than I normally would. Normally I record my Let's Plays after I get home from work, and it's like fuck o'clock in the morning and the world is sleeping, but today I had to record a little bit early because I have plans tomorrow. And they require me to be up early, so I have to go to bed early, so I'm gonna get home from work and then attempt to pass the hell out. So instead you guys get airport noise recordings. That was interesting. I, like, buffered a heal spell or something. Huh, wonder if there's a way to abuse that. Like, what'd I do? This, and then, oh, I don't think there's really any point. You can run around with a spell prepared, and then once combat starts, you can be like, I want to heal Rove, and it works. I don't really think there's any way that I can abuse that over much. It looks like our vitality has worn off. Casters have to focus for their spell points, and we gotta pull paralysis off of her. What is this? Proceed left and south to reach the deep mining zone. What the hell has the rest of this been? Proceed left. I assume that's left of the sign. Deep mining zone ahead. Alright. Well, we'll get there eventually. I want to kind of explore the not-so-deep mining zone first. Just kind of clear out as much as we can here. No, oh, not enough mana, gold leaf. That sucks. Thankfully, the rest of the party's doing okay. We'll probably fight a couple more groups here, and then I'm gonna have to rest before too much longer. I'm basically running on the fumes of the back row right now. Alright, here, we'll just rest here. There we go. I like that, like, even he doesn't even heal. Can't fight or use magic, won't be targeted by monsters. Targeted is misspelled. Immune to some physical effects. Okay, gold leaf. Yeah, I guess you can just fight. I wonder if lightning bolt would perhaps be more useful here, because the melees. Deep mining zone east. The melees cut these guys down pretty good. It's basically just the like, I think the triple eyes, the ones that have like 600 hit points, those are the ones that kind of tend to last through the first volley. of my melees doing what they do. Yeah. Yeah, alright. So lightning bolt, I think, will probably be a little bit better. Less useful on, like, the huge groups, but eh. Let's go ahead and get some healing rocking out here. Magic shield running again. Not that I don't think need magic shield in here. I think all we really need is the vitality for the paralysis immunity, and the rest is just kind of melees soaking the hits. Go ahead and top up the back row. They're getting beat on a little bit more than I would like. Alright. Yeah, we got this. Oh, I see some loot back there. Copper chest. I've noticed that the chests of different colors seem to have, like, different loot, and this is, like, a copper chest. I know there are gold chests. There might also be silver chests, but I honestly don't recall. A hat of royal advisors. Is that worth anything? Confusion, mesmerize, resistance, and its caster gear. Basically, the people that I would give it to already have them, so nothing I care about. Okay, we've poked through, yeah, all of that. So we got some area up here that I apparently managed to miss. I mean, there are a lot of these things in here. Like, this place is monster dense, I have to give it that. Oh my god, seriously, game? With the paralysis. And the back row is running lightly low on mana. I don't think we need a heal. I am gonna have these guys focus though, just to kind of get that out of the way. Alright, there's a bunch of these things here, so I think for this portion of the fight, we're gonna swap over to fireballs. Gotta get Vigor back up on us, because this paralysis is irksome. Can't you... No, you can cure poison. And magic shield us as well. Yeah, against the good-sized groups like that, I think Fireball is probably worth it. I think it's a more... Overall, you're getting more damage out of it. It's economical, I suppose. Less damage individually. But you're hitting everything. I'm waiting to fight, like, the fabled, like, walking quadruple eye. I know there's gotta be one lurking in here somewhere. Just look at all these things. It's ridiculous. Alright, we're gonna back out. I need to rest. I get my casters topped off. Alright, go ahead and re-vitality, re-magic shield, back over here. And just kind of map as we go. I'm gonna really laugh if there's, like, a Cthulhu. We eventually just bump into a great old one, and the party is never seen again. I think I saw a chest to the left as well. Which I am... Oh, I did! Give me that. A mithril longsword, nothing too great. Okay... I don't know, this doesn't feel particularly challenging. It's just kind of a slog. And I mean, I guess that's not necessarily a bad thing, but... Eh. I mean, I guess not every area can be, like, super focused. So I guess I can't complain too much. For all I know, maybe this is just here to give you, like, a place to gain a couple levels, and it has, like, no other purpose. Alright. I'm gonna have these guys focus, get their spell points back. Goldie recover just to kind of expedite our healing a little bit. Okay, and I think this is it. Alright, so that is, I think, everything for this wing. There's, I think, one more to the south. Like down here. Keep mining zone south. But yeah, like, this place is... This has been a pretty good-sized map right here. And I still, like I said, I have to explore that on my way out. So if I had to guess, we're probably going to have to pull back at least one more time for a rest. But past that, we should be okay. I'm actually, like, I am liking, though, that I've had to actually kind of retreat a little bit so that I can have some time to, you know, gather my party's strength again. Vitality is worn off again. It would be nice if they did some graphical flourish on the screen when your buffs wore off, because I know these are down here. And I think I had somebody point it out in the comments as well that these are down here, but I already knew. Wow, that was 3 adamantite ore right there. Very nice. But, like, I don't know, something down there, like, when they dropped off, like, even, like, just a little poof of sparkles or something. Like, that would be enough, I think, to... And I've got Devon casting spells, which he needs to not be doing, because he's useless. Oh, Devon, you try so hard. Yeah, you attack. There you go. I guess Goldleaf can probably attack as well. I don't know, depending on how monster dense this area is, we might not need to flee. I mean, we'll rest when we're done in here, but I don't think we're gonna need to rest again for this area. This seems pretty well focused here. Like, yeah, that was it. Alright, let's go ahead and get out of here while we can. See what is over here. Oh, some more of them. Alright. I'll play your game. Game. Oh, just the wimpy little ones. I mean, we've made, I think, a fair amount of money in here. I think we've made probably like 7,000 gold. Go ahead and heal Rove. Ah, that's not a sound I like to hear. How much mana do you have? You have 2 spell points. It's enough for a magic arrow. Okay, we're gonna have to... I was not expecting, like, a whole other branch of this dungeon. We are now officially out of victuals. Alright, and what I'm gonna do is actually just do this because the day was about to roll over and my buffs were gonna wear off. And ain't nobody got time for that. I'm here to kill shit, not have my buffs run out mid-combat. Alright. Okay, looks like this area here might just be the entirety of this. Yeah. Okay, not too bad. I'm gonna, I think, keep Rove just throwing magic arrows and let Sonrail chew through his mana pool throwing fireballs. Okay, it's a mass heal. I'm only gonna do this enough to top up the back row. Front row's still pretty solid. Alright, let's get out of here. Ah, that wasn't too bad. So I think now we're only missing one. I think we need 6 of these. Yeah, we are now only missing one more. Let's go ahead. Oh, I know we can't. We have to go back here. I was gonna say go and heal Chunk. Yes, here. Yes. All right. Restore. Go to the inn. Replenish. I'm gonna rest. Do a full rest. Replenish. All right. Let's see what kind of levels we're working with here. Wow. 3 levels on Swell. That means I was gonna say, yeah, I'm sure everybody else is gonna be picking up at least 2. power heal and mass power heal. There it is. Woof. Little ways away from that. Firestorm, calling of blizzards, and molten blast. And amplify resistance. Ooh, amplify resistances. That sounds like something that I'll want to just keep on forever. Okay, Devon. I'm going to give you some knowledge. Give you a point of strength, because that's a threshold for encumbrance. Swell. I'll give you some toughness. Chunk, you get nothing. Keep Gold Leaf kind of balanced. Keep Sunrail kind of balanced. I'm excited to see these new spells, though. 17,000 spell points kind of hurts. But I'm excited for it nonetheless. I'm curious of two things. I'm curious what the level cap is, if there is one. And beyond that, I'm curious how long into the game we are going to get progression on stuff. Oh, shit. If we hit info, it gives us like a little bit of blurb about text. A little blurb about the location, I should say. That's kind of nice. I actually wanted this. Let's see. Magic. I don't suppose you guys will have... No. Will you tell me... Nope. Alright, I'm gonna see if there's anything in there to kind of detail level caps and whatnot. Alas, there is not. Well, that leaves us a tower. I'm gonna go ahead and save again. We'll clear this, and then we will call it. I can't imagine this is gonna be... Yeah. Mesmerize. I don't think we can do anything for that. I'm gonna haste us. Just to kind of give us the first go here. And I'm gonna have my back rows be throwing fireballs for this. Because they got numbers. Alright, and you should already be on fireball. Nice. But hey, at least Chunk gets to participate in this one. Jesus. Front row is just like going ham on these guys. I know they have resistances to like elemental stuff. So I suppose it might actually be better. Fire. Alright, so in that case, fireball is probably not the best thing to be doing. Honestly, don't particularly care, but if we can get away with just throwing like one spell point magic missiles, that's okay. Another fairy! Take this magic dust. And more magic dust. So much magic dust. That's a lot of dust! Jesus Christ. Ah, these sorcerers just throwing their bodies at my melees and getting absolutely taken apart. I love it. Okay. Hi, guys. Oh, a sorcerer. Is that... I don't know that we've fought these guys before. Fire and cold resist. I think maybe we have like one of them. I think a sorcerer was at that one. It was that one guy's apprentice in one of the early towers was a sorcerer that we had to kill. He'd like gone mad or whatever. I'm waiting to bump into like an archmage so that we can kill him and then become the archmages, because that's how it all works. I would know. I've become the archmage in several Elder Scrolls games. Oh, we're getting multiple crystals now. Nice. I was wondering how we were expected to hit, like, God, whatever they were requiring of us, like 90 for stuff. There. We have all of the buffs running now, game. Are you happy? If I had the resistance buff, that'd be running too, but instead I'm just running roughshod on these guys because they don't deal nearly enough damage to be an actual threat to anyone in the party. Gotta throw some like mega mages at me. I wanna bump into Mr. Wizard in here and have him just eradicate my entire party with a mass disintegrate spell or something. Wouldn't that be a thing? You play a Might and Magic game and instead of being your bro, Mr. Wizard wants to kill your ass. That'd be terrifying. Not really in character though, I don't think. Ooh, you're new. A master sorcerer. All right, there's the lightning resistance finally kicking in. Sadly, he does not have sword resistance, and the front row is really good at those. So, he tried. Jesus. Friggin' front row just taking these guys apart. It's wonderful. I love it. Ooh, what is that? Some energy fields? You ever see a monster's atlas and arachnid breeding technique. So I'm gonna assume that these are just dungeon traps as opposed to like fields like in say a Ultima game. Yeah. Just some lightning damage. Ain't no thing. I really like that when you're standing on them, it still shows them, but it fades them out instead of like either not showing them or not fading them out. It's a nice, just a little, a nice touch, I will say. It also means that I'm not going to be exploring every square in here, because as much as I love mapping, I'm not going to be just walking through damaged squares just to map everything. Oh, we have a door up here as well. Good try, buddy. Razrix's ring. Quest item, perhaps? No. Razrix was one of the seven wizards of the first Wizards Council. He died in the year 151 in a magic-related accident. During his career, he forged several powerful magic items, and this gives us a lot of immunities and lightning resistance. I'm actually very strongly thinking about giving this to Chunk. I'm going to replace his girdle of strength with that because the immunities, like blanket immunities to everything that is fucking killing him. Faldrix the Warlock, the new owner of Lower Twin Tower. You see a warlock sitting on a granite throne surrounded by an impenetrable sphere of magic. How dare you obliterate my minions! My war with the wizard from the Upper Twin Tower is of no concern of yours! Oh, okay. Well, your minions, they shouldn't have gotten in my way. That's a story that I'm going with. They picked the fight, I ended it. Tends to be a speciality of this party. Alright, so we're actually gonna go ahead and just come back here. We're gonna grab the boat. Cause there's exploring to do! Alright. Whew. Can I cure? I think I can cure Mesmerized. Yes. Basically anything that I can do to not have to pay the temple to do it, cause food is so much cheaper. Alright, anybody? Ah, oh, they're so close. Oh, Chunk. There you go, Chunk. Strength. He lost some, sadly. I'm so excited in this friggin' next session, you guys. We're gonna be getting some new and interesting ways to kill things that probably cost way too much mana. However, that will be for next time. Until then, folks, I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you until next time. That's what I was going to say. I don't know. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you folks around. Until then.